Previously, losing weight in Japan.
Remember this expression?
In deep shit.
That is what I meant. I have a bad
case of diarrhea. I made a bet with a friend that I would lose 10 kilograms in 10 weeks.
いつも渡辺謙のことばっかり話してる。
I need to get to 72 kilograms.
Famous punk rock star.
I'm Hans.
Yeah, babe, she's gone. I pretty much won the bet. Somehow, in the first week of this 10 kilogram, 10 week weight loss challenge, I was able to lose 3 kilograms. And I think it was due to the fact that I was running every day, eating healthier, and fasting for most of the week.
3 kilograms?
Yeah.
Wow. どうやってやったの?
朝食をやめて、脂っこいものを食べなかった。あと、毎日走っていた。
Good.
So.
That said, I don't want to get too cocky, as apparently it's quite easy to lose weight at the start of a diet. It's more...difficult towards the end, and I've still got 7 kilograms to go, so...
I'm 79 kilograms. How much do you weigh?
I'm 65.
Fuck! 65 kilograms. How? What?
So this week it's just a case of sticking to the diet and continuing to exercise, and watching the pounds drop off. Which they will.
Why are Japanese people so thin? What's the secret? Tell me the secret!
Yeah.
Tell me the secret!
more cigarette. Bad life.
This year I've been really lucky to visit some of Japan's best known theme parks, including Tokyo Disney and Universal Studios Osaka. And both theme parks are amazing fun, as I really enjoy queuing and spending the gross domestic product of a small island nation to be able to do that. And with queues of up to 4 hours per ride, the theme parks did not disappoint. But yesterday I went to another theme park with my good friend Natsuki. And I don't know where it was or how we actually got to it, but I can tell you now it was the best theme park I've been to in Japan so far. I mean, I knew we were in for a treat when we arrived at the front gate to be welcomed by the park's beloved mascot, Whoopi the Woodpecker. But the reason the park was so good was simply that there were no queues, and yet there were more roller coasters than there are at Tokyo Disney and Universal Studios combined.
This is better than Disneyland.
There wasn't a single queue all day. From the Whoopi the Woodpecker River Rapid Adventure to the Whoopi the Woodpecker Super Viking Pirate Ship Adventure Boat Ride, and I'm not making that name up.
I won't let history come between me and having fun on this ride. Viking. Pirate. Fuck it.
The theme park even had a Scandinavian garden. And I don't even know what that is. But the real highlight of the theme park was, of course, Whoopi the Woodpecker, with his smiling woodpecker face on every bin, shop front, and fountain across the theme park. And don't even think it. Yeah, it might sound like Woody the Woodpecker, but it's not a rip-off. And they might have similar gestures, but they might be American woodpeckers as well. But it's not a rip-off, okay? It might be a little bit of a rip-off. So for me, over the past 2 weeks, the most exciting thing about this diet has probably been the intermittent fasting, because it doesn't require any pills or powders or anything, it just requires a different way of living by eating for only 8 hours a day. All I have for breakfast is some coffee and some tea, and that sees me through until 12 o'clock midday. It does have its critics, of course. Someone on the last video referred to it as intermittent fasting, which is of course a hilarious play on words. But by sticking to this 8 hour window from midday until 8 o'clock in the evening, I found I haven't been snacking between meals as much, and I have a much greater awareness over what I'm eating and when I'm eating it. And so this is a pretty big improvement, considering after dinner, I used to just sit in a chair, stare at the wall, and gorge myself on chocolate and cholesterol. And now I just sit in the chair and just stare at the wall, and I'm healthier for it. I had a revelation the other day whilst staring at the wall. This diet, this 10 weeks, shouldn't just be about the 10 weeks. It should be about being healthy
forever and try to switch my addiction from unhealthy, crappy snack foods to more healthy, sustainable alternatives. And in fact, the only thing I refuse to try implementing into my diet is lentils, because I swear every day for the last 15 years, somebody somewhere has said, oh yeah, you should eat lentils. No, I don't even know what a fucking lentil is, and I refuse to Google it. But in terms of the things I've been substituting, one of the things I stopped drinking straight away was soft drinks, Coca-Cola, Fanta, Sprite, and this is now what I drink, green tea, bottled green tea. I've always been hesitant to drink this stuff or actually try it, as it looked too healthy to possibly taste good. But it's actually really good. After a few bottles, I've actually grown to like it quite a lot, so that was a good move. And this one here is quite good. It's called Mugicha, wheat tea. As you can see, zero calories, and most importantly, it's got seven sources of health. So you know it's going to be a good drink. And of course, salad makes up a big part of my diet now. When somebody told me you could put this stuff on salad called salad dressing, and it makes the eating of salad an actually enjoyable thing. And I found this really basic recipe that changed everything. It was 3 teaspoons of extra virgin olive oil, 1 teaspoon of vinegar, mix it together, done. And it was amazing. The sharp taste of the vinegar with the leaves and the oil, it all came together. I just wish someone had told me sooner that salad could be good. I even discovered a use for Siri in all of this. I remember when Siri first came out and I was skeptical, but now there's no doubt this is the future. This is it. Siri, how many calories are there in a bottle of Coca-Cola?
Okay, playing Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go.
Went out with some friends last night and jeopardised the diet yet again. But I guess that's to be expected when you sit down to eat lead sausage.
Japanese octopus style. Sausage.
Complete with a little flag. Is it healthy?
It's healthy. Fish meat. Fish.
That is
octopus.
Fish octopus.
Meat.
Octopus style.
Octopus style.
That is awful. That is the definition of awful. Oh man, that's not octopus, that's sausage. That's genuine sausage.
It's lead. Lead.
Lead sausage.
Lead sausage. Unbelievable.
Well,
this is going to be my Japanese dish when I go back home. Just cut a sausage in pieces.
Meat dish. Fish meat.
That is not fish meat.
Pork.
Fish.
Tastes like pork.
Fish meat sauce.
I don't know what it is, but it's not. Doesn't make the final cut. After a week of whoopee woodpeckers and lead sausages, I didn't think my week could get any better until I learned that in order to pass the upcoming Japanese language proficiency test, I'd have to memorise 36 A4 pages of vocabulary. Look at that. 36 pages? I don't even know the current whereabouts of my car keys, let alone try to remember half the Japanese language in 3 months. My standard procedure for when I'm stressed is just to consume loads of unhealthy junk food, but because I can't do that, I've had to divert my attentions on something else. And this is what an addiction to green tea might look like. Still, thank God it's zero calories. Or rather, don't thank God, thank Coca-Cola, because that's who makes this popular brand of tea. People always give Coca-Cola a hard time. Oh, they're full of calories, sugar and diabetes. They're all about profit. Well, 2 weeks ago, I was in Sendai, and as I looked down at the busy street below, there, I saw a group of people going round wearing Coca-Cola sponsored shirts and cleaning the already disgustingly immaculate streets of Sendai at their own time and expense. Would an unethical, power-hungry multinational corporation be cleaning the streets of Sendai? No, of course it wouldn't. All about profit. So that's the second week down. It's time to go and weigh myself. As we can see here, I've been able to do a lot of intermittent fasting this week and keep that up all right. In terms of working out and fitness training, haven't really done that much. That could be a problem, but let's find out. Let the suspenseful music begin.
another kilogram down. That is great. 6 kilograms to go and about 8 weeks to do it in, so it shouldn't be too difficult. Although that said, we are out of easy territory now, as apparently after 2 weeks it becomes more difficult to lose weight as your body readjusts itself to the new diet. So it'll be interesting to see how it goes from here, to be honest, but right now I'm feeling pretty cocky.
Your love is like bad medicine. Bad medicine is what I need. Good.
Bad medicine.
That's quite good. All right, your band is going to do well. From the Whoopi the Woodpecker magic boat ride, bastard fuck. From the Whoopi the Woodpecker, fucking Whoopi the fucking Woodpecker.